Hey guys, today we're going to be going over some best practices for installing a dash camera. Now, for those of you that live in areas that get colder, even if it doesn't snow, take the time, especially on these newer vehicles, is to let the vehicle sit in a climate-controlled shop, or you can also take a heat gun. Be very careful not to let heat stay on there for too long, but when you're disassembling panels, you want to get these up nice and warm. That way, they're less likely to crack. Now, a lot of newer vehicles on the boots, where the wire, factory wire goes through, are doubled up. So you have the boot that is the sheath that seals on this plastic piece. I've been coming across this quite a bit. And you have to take your time with this stuff to get it out, because you have to go all around the sides and unclick it. Don't just pull on the boot, because if you crack these, the only way to put these back on properly if you get a new piece is you have to unwire part of the harness and slip it through. You can see that there's no opening. It's not like you can just slip it on and put a new one in. Like, this is crucial for the seal if you damage this, and you're going to have a world of hurt if you break a clip, because it'll never seal properly. So really take your time. I like to invest in some good pick tools, whatever brand you want. However, you can get the job done to be gentle on these. This is why it's important to get the thing up to room temperature and not work on the vehicle when it's cold. It's gonna be a lot easier to work with these plastics. Next, you'll have to feed the wire through the boot for the rear camera. I find you can just go to the local hardware store and get these giant zap straps. And I like to use glass cleaner as a lubricant to allow it to pass through easier. The reason why I use glass cleaner over, let's say, silicone lube or a lubricant in general is, one, some of those lubricants could be bad for the insulation and start to break apart the rubber on the boot or the insulation. Two, they kind of just stay there like silicone lube. The glass cleaner will eventually evaporate and just go away. So here I attach the wire or my cable with not the most expensive electrical tape. I just use mid-grade 3M. I use Super 33 for other things. This would be a waste of Super 33. But it grabs on just well enough and it's tough enough. Now you can go ahead and pull it through. Now, when you get your wire through, one, make sure you feed through the plastic. Two, feed the wire as you're pulling on it. Don't just pull on it strictly, especially if you're running a lubricant, because you're likely to tear the wire. These are very thin inside. Now, before you put the seals in, take your time and work the boot over the plastic. So you can see here, it's flanged and there's a seal that it has to go into. So we have to make it look like this, and the hardest part is to look behind where you can't see. Take your time, work it on. Use glass cleaner as a lubricant to help work it over. Then you can go ahead and click it in. Now, the heat gun, I would take the time to warm up the glass a little bit. Take your glass cleaner and clean the rear and the front glass. So for your rear camera, be mindful of the orientation. And here we're lucky because the heater lines are quite far. We're not going to go on them in case you ever have to remove it. And I put the chassis centered so it looks good. Like, you could offset it so the camera itself, but it's such a fisheye, it doesn't really matter so much. So I go for looks of the install on this one. So I'm close to the heater line. Light pressure, hold it on, massage it on, do that for a good 10 seconds. Here are the tips for your wiring. Always run with the factory wire because you know it's designed to go there. Now, all these holes do mean something. So we see we have a guide tab here, and then we also have our push pins, so we can't get the wire in the way, because if you were in line of that and you go to push the panel on, you can cut the wiring. We've also added a little bit of a loop here just for servicing. Also, there's another loop in here because, remember, this area articulates all the time, and if it's tight, you can pull and tear the wiring. I've also notched the panel. So camera wire is held in place. because it's so tight to the glass, if we don't notch that, it can chafe the wire there as well. Another tip when dealing with these headliners, don't be too aggressive. Take out as much of the parts you have to that are holding it, like these handles over here. And you have to tuck the wire and possibly tape it to the headliner, because this here is the side curtain airbag. Newer vehicles will all have this equipped now from factory, so we have to go far enough in that this doesn't get in the way of the deployment area. But we also have a big sunroof here, or moonroof, so we can't go too far into that mechanism either. So our front camera's in, same thing, replace in place. So what I like to do is I like to plug in the wires first. So when I put the camera up, I kind of see where it's going to lay, because if I just put the camera as tight as I can, and then I plug it in, like, oh, there's not enough room here for me to plug and unplug it, so we have to make it serviceable. On this car, we just use one little clip here that's as adhesive, some Tessa, tuck it in here, inside the molding here, and run it along. Now, coming over here, we do zap strap to the factory wiring, but you'll see here there's a little drain tube here for the sunroof. I do not zap strap this because if you tighten that, it might cause a kink, and then it's not going to drain water properly. So I fish the zap strap between, zap onto the wiring, not onto the drain tube. And we're on this side on the factory wire because we have another, again, side curtain airbag. It does deploy over here, but we just want to stay away from it. So for our main wiring, we might not be able to always zip tie or zap strap wiring certain sections. So what I've done here is I've taken exterior Tessa tape for an extra layer of protection, and then we secure it to all the factory wires. The ground I've extended, I always recommend you bolt grounds, whether it's a nun bolt onto the subframe that's attached to the chassis, or you find a factory ground bolt, which is even better. Having a tight ground is what you want. Now we have used fuse taps. Now I'm using spares, so it actually, the orientation doesn't matter in this case, because I'm only using the circuit for the camera. Also up top here, I still have maintained the factory fuses that come from Thinkware. So it technically is doubled up, so I put a little bit of a bigger fuse here. I am relying on these fuses to protect the device, but then this allows me to adapt into the vehicle and not be so invasive. Again, running with all the factory wiring, so it's nice and tidy. So luckily on the Ford, in their owner's manual, they still list fuse location, amperage rating, and what it's hooked up to. Not all vehicles do this. You'll have to do research on some. Some are just numbers like this. So luckily we got lucky here. So we can see that we use fuses. What we are going to try to use are spares if available. So you see, like, not used, not used. So anything that is necessary, stay away from. Anything like ABS, ignition. You can use things that are non-essential, like the amplifier, but what you want to really try to find are things that are like this one here, spare, 20 amp. So test if that's on all the time, that can be your battery. If it switches, that can be your accessory turn on. Anything else like anti-lock brake control, anything essential for safety or vehicle operation, please do not use. So your front camera installation, very simple. Everything's tucked away. And we know everything is out of the way of the airbag. And here's the rear dash cam tucked nicely up and high. And once we've completed the installation, we want to go ahead and test it. So this is our front camera. And go check out the rear. And there is our rear view. So we know our orientation is correct. And there you guys have it. Those are the top tips for installing your dash camera.